Hello, my friends. I'm glad to be back with you with another one of our Washington Bites, our series of brief talks, just a few minutes, in which I lay out one issue in each of them. The issue before us right now, and I'm afraid it is not going to go away anytime soon, is the situation in Syria, the allegation by the Obama administration that this was use of chemical weapons, which I think is verified by the United Nations team and others, and the allegation that it was done by the Assad regime, which still is questioned by the Russians and others, but looks like it was the Assad regime that perpetrated this atrocity against the 1925 Convention against the Use of Chemical Weapons. So this is not the first use of chemical weapons, even in Syria. There have, by various reports, been as many as 12 or 14 such attacks by President Bashar al-Assad, and there was a particularly horrific attack more than 30 years ago by his father. So, and of course, we know that Saddam Hussein gassed some 5,000 of his Kurdish citizens before he was deposed. So chemical weapons have been used. There were even allegations that Egyptian forces used them at one point when they were intervening in civil war in Yemen many years ago. But this does not excuse the use of chemical weapons by the Assad regime or anyone else. The question is, what is in the United States' national security interest? And I'm firmly convinced that it is not, I say not, in the U.S. national security interest to have the proposed military strike or strikes by the U.S. military against facilities in Syria right now. This is a faulty use of tactics which are not fitted into a proper strategy, much less into a complete policy as to what we want to see happen in Syria. The administration never has articulated clearly its policy for what it is aiming, what its aims are in Syria. Neither has the Congress been able to complete its work. Last year, thankfully, the House, led by Congresswoman Chairman Ileana Ross Leighton of Florida, passed almost unanimously the Syria Freedom Support Act. This year, the Senate Foreign Relations Committee ordered reported out the Syria Democracy Transition Act. Each of these bills, in its own style, would set an overall policy that protects U.S. national security interests, that looks after the security interests of Israel and our other friends or relative allies in the Middle East, and also works toward a transition toward real democracy in Syria. Real democracy meaning that someone could stand up in the town square of Damascus and say whatever he or she wants to do without fear for their life and property. It also would have supervised elections, and it would have protection for the rights of Christians and other minorities who frankly are threatened and feel threatened by the proposed overthrow of President Assad. That brings me to the final point. We do not know who will replace President Assad if, as presently is unclear, he is deposed or overthrown by the rebels, perhaps with our assistance. In the opposition are forces related to Al-Qaeda, the movement, of course, that perpetrated the 9/11 atrocities, attacks on the World Trade Center and on the Pentagon and more. And there are other Salafists and radical Islamic groups who are opposed to President Bashar al-Assad and who seem to be in the ascendancy in the rebel forces. So many, many questions that need to be answered before there's any decision by the Congress to approve a military action by the administration. In addition, although I was very pleased to see that the President was sending this up to the Congress for authorization, for approval, he now appears to be saying that even if the Congress doesn't approve it, he can act militarily under his inherent powers as Commander-in-Chief. I think this is unfortunate, unconstitutional, illegal, and unwise. We have no allies, we have no public support to speak of in America, and we do not have a strategy for how we get out of a war in Syria if we stumble in now. So for all these reasons, I am urging the Congress to vote against the President's proposal for military action unless there's much more of a groundwork laid, and I am urging all of you to tell your senators and representatives to vote against this ill-considered measure. It's not that we favor Bashar al-Assad, God forbid, or the use of chemical arms, but we must do something that we can be sure is going to be effective and is going to achieve our aims. But first, we have to articulate what our national aims are. We'll say more of this in future, I'm sure, but thank you for your cooperation. Thank you for your actions as citizens to be in touch with your senators, with your representatives, and even with the White House on this issue. Thank you very much.